33 Notion tips to increase your productivity. Whether you're a student, a business professional, or just somebody looking to get more organized, these Notion tips will help you streamline your workflow and boost your productivity to the next level. There will be 11 tips about Notion itself, 11 tips on increasing your productivity with Notion, and 11 tips for making your Notion dashboard more aesthetic and enjoyable to use. Let's get started with the first Notion tip, which is all about the new subtasks feature. In a table view database, you now have the option to create database entries within database entries. To access this feature, go into the database menu and click on sub items. Let's rename the sub items to tasks and the parent property to projects, and then click on create. Now you'll see two new relation properties and this toggle next to the database entries. Add your different projects, and then inside of the dropdown, you can add your tasks. You can even add more database entries inside of the tasks, and even more inside of that one. You can go infinitely deeper, similar to how you can have pages within pages infinitely. The next step is to make use of dependencies when using a timeline view. Similar to subtasks, you can go into the menu and create dependencies. This allows you to link different database entries and make them dependent on each other, meaning you have to finish the first task before you can move on to the second one. This works great in teams if people are working on the same project but require another teammate to finish their task before they can start working. Next up, we have the recurring templates. Let's say for example you have a daily journal and a habit tracker that you fill out every day. In a calendar database grouped according to the created time property, you can go into the dropdown next to new and add a recurring template button. You can repeat this template button daily, weekly, monthly, or yearly. For the daily journal, we are going to repeat this template button daily and select the date it should start on and also a specific time. Now every morning at a specific time, you'll have a new daily journal ready for you to be filled out. You can also take it a step further and link a line graph to your habits to visualize the progress of your habits throughout the month. Check out my dynamic habit tracker video linked in the description below for more information about this. Staying in the template buttons, the next step is to set the template button as default for generating an icon. Instead of creating a new task and adding an icon manually each time, you can just create a template button and set it as default. Now each time you create a new task, the icon will automatically be applied. When using template buttons in a project and task management system, you can create a self-referencing task database that automatically loads every time you create a new project with that template button. Simply create your template button and copy the link of your task database and paste it inside of the template button. Then just filter the task database to that current template button. So every time you create a new project, you'll have the tasks database inside showing all the tasks relating to that specific project. When using relations, you can set which properties you want to show by clicking the property menu and selecting the properties you want, and you can also change how relations are being displayed. You can view a relation as its own section at the bottom or as a minimal view, which works similar to how backlinks are displayed. If you want to create multi-column layouts, you simply drag and drop the blocks you want wherever you want them. If you want to create multi-column layouts with databases, then you first need to use empty blocks and drag and drop your databases inside. And if you want to create multi-column layouts inside of multi-column layouts, you'll need to copy a multi-column layout, create a toggle, paste it inside of the toggle, drag the toggle underneath the column, turn it into text, and delete the toggle with backspace, and now you'll have a multi-column layout inside a multi-column layout. If you're using a simple table and you want to organize it, instead of manually dragging all the blocks around, you can turn the simple table into a table database, use the filter and sort options to organize the database, and then turn it back into a simple table. If you're using lots of checkboxes in a database and you want to reset all the checkboxes, then simply create a table view, deselect the checkbox, and then use the circle at the bottom right corner of the cell and drag it all the way down to copy and paste the value to all the others. Alternatively, you can deselect the checkbox and click copy, then while holding in shift, you can select all the other checkboxes and then just click paste. Some of you might already know this, but inside the Notion settings under the Earn Credits tab, you're able to perform certain actions and earn credit which you can then use to get the paid versions of Notion for free, which is pretty cool. And also under the Settings tab, you're able to change the domain of your Notion templates if you're sharing them with others. The last step for this first section is to use the built-in Notion templates or templates from the Notion gallery to find inspiration for your workspace, and so you don't have to start from a blank canvas. Also, feel free to check out my 9 free Notion templates video after watching this one. Now for the 11 Notion tips that's going to help you be more productive. The first tip is to make use of the new multiple tabs feature for the Notion desktop app by clicking on the plus in the top left. You can also right click on a database entry or a page and select open a new window to create a new tab. And you're also able to go back and forward pages using the arrows next to the tabs. This next tip is for people using Notion on their phone. Create a synced block with a template button inside for quickly adding notes, and then you want to create a new page and then paste the synced block inside. Now every time you quickly want to capture a new idea, you can pull up this page on your phone and add a new note. This will then sync with your main dashboard, so when you're at your computer again, you can easily organize your notes into tasks, projects, or anything else. Keyboard shortcuts is important to learn if you want to increase your efficiency when using Notion. Here's all the keyboard shortcuts for the basic Notion blocks that you'll use most often. Heading 1, 2, and 3 can be created with 1, 2, or 3 hashtags. A to-do list is both the left and right square bracket. A toggle is the greater than symbol. A bullet list is the minus symbol. A numbered list is the number 1 with a full stop. A quote block is a quotation mark. And a divider is 3 minus symbols. For more keyboard shortcuts, check out the website linked in the description below. If you want to quickly find Notion pages, you can use the search feature by clicking on search in the top of your sidebar or by using the shortcut Ctrl and P. Here you can type in the name of the page you're looking for or the content contained inside of that page, and then just filter the search results with the options at the top. Managing your time effectively is crucial for optimizing your productivity, so I'd recommend having a main Notion calendar. Just copy the link of your task database and paste it at the bottom of your dashboard as a calendar view. This way you'll always be able to visually see what's on your schedule for each day, week, and month, and you can also easily create new tasks, meetings, or events on a specific day and also drag them around and rearrange them. Having a main calendar is a must-have for any Notion user. Over time, you'll have more and more Notion pages to navigate between, and usually you'll have a select few that you use almost daily. I'd recommend favoriting those pages by clicking the star in the top right or by using the shortcut Ctrl, Alt, Shift, and F. This will make your pages show up under the Favorites tab in the left sidebar, making it a lot easier to get to. If you have lots of different pages and constantly move between them using your sidebar, then stop. Rather create a main Notion dashboard with all your most important views, and then create a list view database containing all of your different pages, grouped according to their type. You can use a simple select property to group them, or you can group them according to a relation property which allows you to also add an icon, which just looks a lot better. For this, simply create a separate database with your different life areas underneath your dashboard and then hide it inside of a toggle. Then just use a relation property to link the two databases and then group your list view according to that relation. Now all your pages are neatly organized into one database, and you can access everything in Notion from your single dashboard. To take this one step further, you can add a navigation bar that instantly takes you to your most used Notion pages. For this, you want to create a heading 1, and then use the colon to search for emojis, or you can browse through the emojis by pressing the Windows key and the full stop. Select a relevant emoji for each different page and leave a space in between. Now you want to copy the page link, highlight the emoji and the space next to it, and then hit paste. Repeat this for every single emoji and you'll end up with a nice looking navigation bar. Now all you have to do is create a synced block, drop your navigation bar inside, click copy, and then paste it inside of every page linked in the navigation bar. And now you can effortlessly navigate between your Notion pages. Next is the Notion Web Clipper Chrome extension, allowing you to quickly save any website, video, or link directly to a Notion database. I'd recommend this database to be a gallery view database with a URL and a tag property to categorize the bookmarks. When you want to save a website, simply click on the Chrome extension in the top right, select your database, and click Save to Notion. Your website will be saved and automatically embedded inside your Notion database. As for the phone, the Notion Web Clipper already comes built in with the app, so if you want to use it, simply just share a link to Notion. This next tip is for people using tools outside of Notion to manage their life, like for example Google Calendar. You can use an integration software like Zapier or Make to set up an app automation between two different apps. You simply link the accounts of the apps you want to use and create a new automation. Then you set up an app trigger, for example every time a new Google Calendar entry is created, and then you set up an app action, which is caused by the trigger. For example, once a Google Calendar entry is created, then create a new database entry inside of my Notion calendar. I already have a full Zapier tutorial showing you how to set up an app automation between Notion and Google Calendar, but you can link pretty much any external app you can think of with Notion. The last tip for the productivity section is to simply watch more content about Notion on YouTube. When you start watching Notion content on YouTube, you realize there are a ton of stuff you can do with Notion that you didn't even know was possible. Now for the 11 aesthetic tips to make your Notion look a lot better and much more enjoyable to use. The first tip is all the basic aesthetic options, beginning with the option to change your Notion to dark mode by going to the notifications and settings tab and toggling on dark mode. Or you can use the shortcut key Ctrl, Shift and L. And then you'll also want to click the toggle at the top left to hide the sidebar. Inside the page menu on the top right, you can change the Notion font, make the text small, and also change the page to full width. You're probably already familiar with the custom Notion icons and covers, but did you know you can also add animated icons and covers? You can find a bunch of animated icons and covers on Pinterest, and I'll leave a link in the description of my Notion cover pinboard. You can also use Pinterest to find animated icons, or you can create your own using Canva. Simply create a square canvas and go to the Elements tab, search for the type of icon you want, and filter the search results by animated. Then under graphics, you can select your icon, resize it, and then download it as a GIF. When you upload it to Notion, you'll notice it has a white background, so if you want to remove it, you'll need to go to the website linked in the description and simply upload your GIF and then download it again. Now when you upload it to Notion, the white background will be gone. If you want to add a clock and button widget like the ones I have on my dashboard, then you can easily create one using Indify.co. Simply select one of the widget options, like the clock for example, and play around with the different customization options until you're happy with the result. Then copy the link and paste it inside of Notion as an embed and align it to the left. Now just resize your widget and place it wherever you want. I'll leave links in the description to a bunch of different Notion widget websites which you can check out and play around with. When using multi-column layouts inside of single width pages, you can extend the multi-column layouts beyond the margins of the single width page by just dragging the gray bar. When using a board view, you have the option to toggle on colored columns under the layout tab to color the whole column instead of just the title. In a table view database, you can go into the layout tab and remove the vertical lines to get a more simplistic look. Now we're getting into customizing the Notion databases. The first step is to hide all the database titles and also to remove the database names by replacing them with a space. If you're using multiple views for specific reasons, then of course add names to your views, but make them all lowercase letters if you want a cleaner look. Now for my favorite aesthetic tip, callout boxes. Add a callout box set to the default color and drag and drop your database inside. Now add a name to your callout box and make the text bold, underline it, and change the color to match the theme of your dashboard. And also don't forget to add a Notion icon. You can also make the title of your callout box in all caps and add a space in between each letter for a more minimalist look and feel. And because our database is inside of callout boxes, it also makes it a lot easier to drag around and create multi-column layouts with. Inside your database, you're also able to change the icon for each individual property or view by simply clicking on rename and then changing the icon next to the title. My last aesthetic tip is to use the gallery view databases to clearly display different properties. Simply set the card preview to none under the layout section and then use the property menu to select which properties you want to display. And if you want to hide the title, then simply replace it with a space. And if you want to separate different properties, then add a text property with a space and drag the text property wherever you need it. And there you have it, 33 Notion tips. If you have learned anything new from this video, then I'd really appreciate a like and make sure to check out my full Notion guide to help you go from a total beginner to a Notion pro in less than 20 minutes.